Officially welcome to the 5th annual New Venture Challenge at the Scheinfeld Center. Give yourselves a hand. My name is Julie Sampson, and I'm the Executive Director of the Scheinfeld Center. Over the last 6 years, the Scheinfeld Center has matured, and we consistently now have 200 students enrolled in our enterprise, in our entrepreneurship courses every semester. And we host significant community and regional services. For instance, the Small Business Development Center, which provides one-on-one counseling and coaching to small businesses anywhere in Santa Barbara County at no cost to clients. And many of our student businesses have taken advantage of this service as they matriculate from here to the outside world. In 2014, we became host to the Center for International Trade and Development. We promote exports in the region, and we have joined with the State Chancellor's Office in the Doing What Matters campaign for jobs and the economy. This year, we have two schools that we are welcoming here at the high school New Venture Challenge tier. And that is Santa Barbara High School. And Lompoc High School. So as you are probably aware, the high school portion gives away $2,000 in cash prizes. And these are generously donated by Montecito Bank and Trust and the Spirit of Entrepreneurship Foundation. Plus, the winning students get to participate in a $25,000 scholarship fund through the generous donation of the Bank of Santa Barbara. Please give a hand to our sponsors. But I must tell you, it doesn't end there. Because the students who are finalists and compete in the New Venture Challenge have all sorts of opportunities available to them. For instance, Doug Lynch, who is the founder of Goleta Entrepreneurial Magnet, made an announcement early on before the collegiate
tier. And he said that doesn't matter whether it's high school students or college students, winners or finalists, what is available and what you can apply for is a scholarship to be in their summer program in the incubator.
Nice.
Yes. So there will be details about that coming forward to you. And he explicitly said it's not just for collegiate, it's open to high school as well. So it could be very wonderful. Before we get started, I would like to introduce our collegiate judges. You bring with you a wealth of entrepreneurial experience, and it's an honor to have you before us today, benefiting our students. We have Michael Holliday with Synergy Incubator. Michael. We have Daniel Colbert with North Energy Ventures. Daniel. And we have David Goldmuntz, our financial expert. All right, are we ready to begin? Excellent. I'm going to tell you a bit about how we're going to run the show here. Each team from Santa Barbara High School has up to 8 minutes to pitch, and those from Lompoc have 5 minutes to pitch. We will make sure to keep you on track with that, and both teams afterwards have 2 minutes for judges' questions. Both the 8-minute pitches and the 5-minute pitches are all available and up for winning the awards. This just has to do with how we thought the structure would best work to serve your students. 2 minutes for the judges generally gives enough time for one judge or the three judges each to ask one question. And so we ask that you cooperate with each other. And we do have a timer, so we'll time the 2 minutes, and you'll just know if you're running over, you'll hear the timer go off. Okay? Let's see. Any questions? Okay. Well, great. Let's go ahead then and start with our first team. We have up Finding Common Ground with Madeline Mender. And judges, are you ready? And Chris, are you ready? Okay, great.
Okay. As Dr. Jane Goodall says, every individual matters. Every individual has a role to play. Every individual makes a difference. I'm here today to tell you the difference that myself and my team have made. My name is Maddie Mender, and I'm the CEO of Finding Common Ground. I stand here before you to not only seek funding, but to also provide the opportunity for other students to become social entrepreneurs, while solving problems and making money. Finding Common Ground is a unique partnership between two high schools, Escuela Agricola de San Francisco and Donsnet Cafe. The Donsnet Cafe is a school of business with 14 student-run and successful businesses. Escuela Agricola de San Francisco is a school that teaches children of poor farmers to become rural entrepreneurs. Due to both schools' unique contributions, Tom Shoes, a mutual connection, decided to introduce us to one another, stating they believed we must meet and do something amazing. And we have done just that. After much deliberation through our bi-weekly Skype sessions, we established a business that sells handmade jewelry made by the indigenous Toba tribe of the Paraguayan Amazon. We established a unique distribution channel because distance did initially seem to be an obstacle. The Escuela Agricola students take trips down to the Toba tribe, where the indigenous members make the bracelets out of recycled and repurposed materials. Once there, the students buy the jewelry, giving the Toba tribe a beneficial immediate income. Upon their return, the students sell their jewelry to the Donsnet Cafe, and in turn receive a beneficial immediate profit. The US team ends up taking the biggest risk, to go out and sell to a non-captive customer. Entrepreneurs take risks, and all risks have paid off. I am pleased to share that our first shipment has sold out, and we have placed another, giving us the ability and opportunity to repeat the business cycle. As social entrepreneurs, a portion of our profits are given to charity. Our goal is to continuously do good in the world by helping neglected and abused elderly elephants make their way to sanctuaries. We do this by donating 25% of our total profits to the Umbrella Elephant Fund of Santa Barbara. The Escuela Agricola students keep a portion of their profits in order to provide financial support to build an orphanage. Santa Barbara is known for its beauty. We are blessed with amazing weather. Santa Barbarians are people who are long to help out others, enjoy and support the arts, and are especially passionate about helping the environment. Those factors will definitely help us to contribute in our contribution and helping us complete our triple bottom line, which is improving business education, providing financial support to three different groups in need, and, as I previously stated, helping a neglected elderly elephants. In addition, studies do show that customers will buy a product if it supports a cause over one that does not. We will interact with and sell to our customers at the many Santa Barbara events that celebrate and support what our customers value. We have already attended Earth Day and are excited to be working at Soul Festival. We have agreed to exchange our volunteer time for an in-kind table to sell our jewelry. We have a diverse target market range of age, from I do not eat jewelry to 100 plus. Santa Barbara is home to a very diverse customer base of 90,000 people with a median income of $65,000. Although this is our median income, Santa Barbara is called home by many wealthy people who we will target. Finding common ground is a part of the jewelry industry, and we realize there is a lot of competition out there. However, we also realize that jewelry is a great gift. It's personal and easy to package. Here's a chart of our local competitors. As you can see, our local competitors lack doing some good in the world. Their average prices are higher, and only world market comes close to meeting our triple bottom line. Our product is a product for anyone and everyone who is all for supporting a good cause and youth entrepreneurs. Our bracelets can be worn by both males and females, adults and children. Our products are reasonably priced and allow our business to utilize a customer-based pricing strategy. The Escuela Agricola students were shocked to hear that we would pay $2 a piece while simultaneously making over 100% profit. In Paraguay, the currency is called a guarani. One US dollar is equivalent to 4,727 guaranis. With the money gained, the Toba tribe can buy either 20 kilograms of rice, 21 liters of water, or 22 loaves of bread. We promote finding common ground through our social media, our Facebook page, story cards, events, and word of mouth. We also have a rather brilliant way on how to franchise finding common ground. We call it a business in a box. This is how we will seek funding and provide the opportunity for other students to become social entrepreneurs. Within a business in a box, it will include two customized t-shirts made by the Don's Net Cafe, a business plan, an invoice, and enough startup jewelry. My team is made up of hardworking and motivated students who are active members of Dr. Jane Goodall's Reach and Shoot organization. Here I am with Dr. Jane Goodall herself in the 2013 Rose Bowl Parade. Some may consider it a weakness that our jewelry is not mass-produced and that it varies in style. No two are alike. Shipping also takes a while, 5,796 miles to be exact. Our greatest opportunities lie from the support of our advisory board. We also have a very highly exclusive relationship with the Toba tribe, meaning that the Escuela Agricola students had to negotiate in order to sell their jewelry to us, giving us the possibility to sell the one-of-a-kind jewelry in the United States. There are a few threats that are imminent in our marketplace, most obvious being bigger, better-financed companies that may have more resources at their disposal. In addition, teens are not always seen as reliable. Communication is key in this business. Every department has an important function, from tracking an order to delivery. We have a very active and very affluent advisory board that supports us on a daily basis. Our income statement shows that Finding Common Ground turned a profit the end of this January. Our balance sheet shows the financial position of our company. Although our figures are still relatively low by normal accounting standards, we are a startup business. We use QuickBooks Pro and Excel to keep track of all finances. We invested a total of $98 as our total startup costs. This is really low. Having said that, anyone can come up with $98, but what they really need is true passion. True passion can take any business from mediocre to an all-time success. We broke even by the end of this January as well. We have created a sales forecast for the 2014 to 2015 school year to help us focus on which events we should attend and the potential earnings that we have. Keep in mind we're being fairly modest here and do expect our potential earnings to be much higher. I am here today to find common ground between us all. An investment from you will not only help to buy a hefty supply of merchandise, but also bring us closer to our goal of doing some good in the world. This is the circle of winners. In finding common ground, the Escuela Agricola students win, the customers win, the Toba tribe wins, and the Don Sant Cafe wins. So I invite you today to come and join the circle of winners as an investor. Thank you.
Okay, judges, we'll give you 2 minutes for your questions.
Great presentation. Have you tested this market within the high school realm too? Tell us how that's worked.
So we have tested our business in the high school as well as in the community. So we have a Facebook page and we market throughout the high school on the bulletin, on our Facebook page, and we have continuous visitors in the Don Sant Cafe and we market to them and it just keeps continuously growing.
And the students are participating and buying some of it?
Yes, awesome. They're buying all of it.
Oh, good.
I love the enthusiasm. Really nice presentation. In your costs, are you going to have to make trips down to Paraguay periodically, and is that embedded in your costs?
No. So how we work out getting the products to us is Claire Burt, which is the teacher down in Paraguay, she has family that comes and visits her a lot, as well as she comes up here a lot, so they're willing to pack the jewelry in with their belongings, and then they sell it, they ship it to us, when they get home, and they usually live in LA or Miami. So our shipping costs are not very high.
A great presentation. One question. If you're successful, how scalable is your business at the production end?
So ours, we cannot mass produce our products because they are handmade. However, we can have the ability, we do have the ability to kind of have like people on like a waiting list to buy our jewelry. So we kind of have to just wait, and we can only really do monthly shipments of our products.
Great. Thank you, judges.
Thank you.
Let's give them a hand. Thank you, Madeline and Julia. Okay, next up we have Don's Net Gaming, Joshua Palma. And let's see, is this Maxwell? Okay, Maxwell Light.
Hello, everyone. Before I begin, I would like to thank each and every one of you for coming here for supporting us. My name is Joshua Palma, and I am the CEO of Don's Net Gaming. Gaming is a $93 billion industry, and is also a popular demand not being made. Don's Net Gaming will meet this demand and will be ready to make gaming sessions and tournaments. Let the games begin. Our business objectives are to, number one, provide a safe environment for students and teens to play during and after school and also during the summer. We will do this by hosting sessions, tournaments, and summer camps. Challenge cross-county rival Dos Pueblos to a grand tournament. This on May 16, and you all are invited. Our second business objective is to break gaming stereotypes. Gamers are seen as violent and antisocial. Well, we're here to tell you that gamers are actually the opposite of that. See, gaming is considered a sport nowadays, and for a sport, there must be bond. There must be bondings between the teams, and they have to socialize with one another. And our third business objective is, of course, that's why we're here, to seek funding. The funding will go to hosting our tournament, not only making it memorable across for future games and sessions and tournaments, but to make it the greatest tournament that we can have today. See, we do not have anyone targeting this market at the moment, but with many great ideas comes challenges. Our first obstacle was, number one, getting the video games. We made a letter and we spoke to our principal, John Becchio. We asked him if we could play M-rated games. Now, as a parent, you might be a little concerned about M-rated games. See, that's where our second this is where our second obstacle comes in place. We made a student-parent contract notifying the parents that their teens will be playing M-rated games. Now, I know you may be a little bit concerned. However, we will be not playing some games that are way too violent and gory. A third obstacle actually fell really nicely into place. After a business trip from San Francisco, we noticed that many of the teens in the bus were actually playing handheld devices, games. So we challenged another high school that was very eager to know about this. This spurred a tournament. This is where the tournament will fall into place. And the last objective is, that's why we're here. We're seeking funding for the startup cost, which is $1,000. This will go for paying the tournament feed. This will go for paying the tournament's cost, which will be providing the shirts for the team, getting shirts for in the audience, and we will be playing the trophy. The trophy will be a commemorative trophy going from winner to winner of next year's and so on and so on, so they can show off pretty much. Just talk. My team is organized not only by my fellow students, but also by gamers, people who I know, people who I trust. They use the computers a lot, and they are very familiar with the programs. And our revenue pressure will actually be 14,000 over the span of 3 years. We will fill this demand by selling foods during sessions, which are Tuesdays and Fridays, during lunch and after school. We will make revenue as well by selling shirts, which have a prototype today. These are one of the shirts that we got from our Brother Venture Designing Cut. Here you are. These will go for $10 during tournaments. However, that's only the beginning. We can charge more as the gross people come in faster. Our piece for marketing are our product. Our product will be the gaming sessions, tournaments, food, snacks. We will also sell shirts, and we will charge admission fee. Also, the camp will be a product. Our placement room is room 70, a heavily transited room by teens during lunch and after school. Our 4P is pricing, which is, nowadays, tournaments, just to compete in them, go anywhere from 60 to higher, depending on the video game and the people. Our tournaments will be $5 for now. However, over time, they will increase. Also, for viewing is very expensive. It goes from anywhere from $27 to $50, which is outrageously. However, we will only tap this by one. Try not to scare off a target market. These are teens. They are not very rich. However, if we get enough of them, we can increase the value over time. We will also sell shirts as well. And in how this reflects to major tournaments, they can go anywhere from $27 higher. Food and drinks will be $5 an item, and as you all may know, in the stadium or somewhere, it gets really expensive. It goes from $5 to $20 apiece. Our last P is promotion. We will use social media to not only interact with our customers, but we keep them updated. We use sites such as Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and our school bulletin. By showing one video, our room was packed a day afterwards. Special consideration goes towards you. We answer the need for keeping kids off the street and provided keep them out of trouble. Somewhere between the transition of getting out of school and going home, they could be many violent things, such as street graffiti or disturbance of the peace. We will provide a game room that allows people to come in and play and interact with each other. But for that, breaking the stereotype as well of socialization. We will also socialize gamers, which will break the bond of them getting, it's not being rough against each other. It will play competitively. However, they will be playing on teams. This is Dawson Gaming, and thank you.
Judges, questions?
Great. Thank you. Go ahead.
Yeah. Nice presentation. I'm a little confused. I don't know what your breakdown of revenue is between all the different components, but as far as the entry fee, the one competitor you mentioned charges $60,
yes,
which you cited as outrageous, and I think you're charging $5.
Yes, that's for joining in the tournament.
So I guess my question is, normally when you see a competitive situation, you don't see you know, that dramatic? What's the need? You know, you can undercut in price to increase market share, but is there really a need to drop so far below?
Actually, all of these competitors are teens, and as we all know, teens are not very, they don't have a lot of income. So we don't want to scare them off or push them away with the price being so high.
Related question, are there free online games you can join?
Yes, some of the games...
Second part of it is, from what I understand, you can game from anywhere. And
yes.
You can join a game from your bedroom, from wherever. What's the attraction of being in the same room where you're all on computers versus going home, doing homework, and then gaming?
Well, gamers can interact with each other. It brings a lot of friendship in the room, which not many gamers have in high school. They're kind of isolated in their own kind of rooms. It gives them the opportunity to join a group and have friends to hang out with and talk about anything at the in school.
Okay. Yeah, one question. Have you guys thought about the kind of competitive aspect, especially between the high schools? Because it seems like the camaraderie is really what you're offering, because you can be online and not know anybody that you're doing, and you're really trying to build a bond. And then if you have a trophy that goes back and forth between the high schools, then they could sort of be a competitive market that way. Have you thought about that?
Yes. We will actually, that's why we challenged those Pueblos to bring other high schools into this, as well as Lompoc, if you guys wouldn't mind, we would like to challenge you for a year to come.
Yeah. Great, thank you.
So, yeah, this will go around county. Thank you very much.
Awesome, great. Don's Net Gaming, thank you so much. Next up, we have Fell Design with Mackenzie Fell.
Hi, I'm Mackenzie Fell, and I am Fell Design. My business is a graphic design and online marketing business. There are dozens of new businesses and new nonprofits every year, and our world is largely technology-based, and many people are not so much. My business is here to bridge that gap. My business is here to create marketing and online services for all the businesses that are in need. We are here to help other companies gain sales through marketing, online, and across all media platforms. We are to establish an image for new companies. I will offer business logos, business cards with a corporate identity, and website design and social media designs. Fell Design offers three primary packages. The first package is corporate identity, which is a business logo, a business card, and a letterhead. The second package is the basic package, which is corporate identity along with a new website for the business, and then the third package is the premium package, which is corporate identity, a new website, and social media platforms. And for the basic and premium packages, we offer at an extra price campaigning on the websites and social media pages, whereas I post photos and videos that the company can either give me or I can take from the company, and they tell me how long they would want this campaign to go. These are some of the things I have completed. I run an Instagram for a restaurant called California Grill and Rotisserie. I just post a photo, I take that of the food, and then, or they take the photo, send it to me, and then I make up a caption and post it on Instagram. This is a logo that I made for our school's football team through the Don's Net Cafe's design and cut business. And this is a logo I made for our Santa Barbara's Earth Day, the 45th anniversary. Fell Design's target market are small to mid-sized businesses along with nonprofits. You can see that I've already completed work for the Don's Net Cafe, the design and cut business, where I've designed logos for the football team as well as the soccer and basketball team. I've also run an Instagram for the California Grill and Rotisserie, and I've created the Earth Day design. This is my competitor's prices, and this is how I show that I have charitable acts along with my cheaper prices, which will make my product more desirable. This is my cash flow for 1 year. I plan to make $10,058 with however many that I get. Customers will be reached through the Donsnet Cafe, through my own social media sites that I have, which are all free from cost, my social media accounts, and Mad Academy, which is an academy that I'm in at the school called Multimedia Arts and Design. And we take classes through that, such as web design and graphic design, and client referrals through the Mad Academy directors. These are my financial projections. My graphic design, I can make a basic logo for a flat price of $19, and on top of that is the $25 per hour rate. I can make just what social media outside of the packages, which is a $49 flat price. My first package is corporate identity, which is a flat price of $49. My second package, the basic package, is $795, and the corporate identity with web-based and social media is the premium, which is $1,295. And then on top of those, I can add on the annual maintenance. I am asking for a $1,500 investment with 5% equity and 5% interest over the next 24 months. I am the founder of Fell Design. Leanne Nodal is my business advisor, and AJ Henning, who is a director in the Mad Academy, is my graphic design advisor. I am here as a digital native. I grew up in this technology-based society. I've worked with technology for all of my life, and this is why I'm here to help older businesses who may just be adapting to our technology-based society, and I can provide them with this services since I had training from the Mad Academy, the Multimedia Arts and Design Academy, where I had web design, graphic design, film design and editing, and photography classes, and also Mad Studio at the marketing side of the Mad Academy. So we market on web design and social media, and then my training through the Donsnet Cafe. This is my business card, and thank you very much.
Judges.
I'll start. Excellent presentation.
Thank you.
A question on how you differentiate yourself from your competitors. I know you do it on pricing because you're less expensive. What other types of differentiation do you see in your product versus others?
Well, because I have so much experience from the Mad Academy and from Donsnet Cafe and being younger and already being adapted to this technology-based society, I feel like I have a good presence in the technology and that I can really help out older businesses who are not as adapted so that they will use me because of I've had all this training all my life and all throughout high school and junior high.
Thank you.
Question on the production of this. Is this mostly online platform that you're thinking about launching, or is there a sort of other printing or other components of it?
Well, I create the designs with the Adobe programs, Illustrator and Photoshop, and then that can be, these would be web-based right. mostly, but then I can print out business cards if needed, or I can make the business card online and then refer them to another area to print out the designs. And then for the websites and social media, that's all web-based. Yeah.
I'm sure you were nervous, but you have a nice, relaxed style, so that was very good. I'm gonna, as a venture capital investor, I'm gonna ask one of those vicious VC questions.
Okay.
You're the only one so far who has been brave enough to propose a valuation. You said $1,500 for 5%, so you have a post money valuation of $30,000. I'm just curious how you arrived at that.
Well, I decided I took in my startup costs, and I would like, and so that's what I needed to get the Creative Cloud through Adobe and use for other products that I need.
Not the capital required, but how did you place that valuation on your company? It's okay.
I'm not sure.
It's almost an unfair question. Okay. I'll let you off the hook.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mackenzie. And next up, we have Blue Puzzle Project with Katie Pullman. Okay, whenever you're ready.
Did you know that autism is on the rise and that there are 1 in 68 children affected with autism? Hi, my name is Katie Pulliam, and my business is called the Blue Puzzle Project. The Blue Puzzle Project raises funds for autism education and assistance by selling t-shirts and half for autism awareness, and half of the revenue will go towards education for autistic students who need more money for education. And my management team will consist of Sue Copeland, Lompo Kai FBLA Cash Academy, Daryl Johnson, graphic designer, and Tim Harrington, SBDC representative of Lompo. Since there are 14.7 per 1,000 children diagnosed with autism, I have conservative assumptions that each child has 4 family members or friends that would be supporting autism. There are 308 million people in the United States that with a projected 18 million family and friends of autistic children. My first year goal is an ultra conservative of 2,000 t-shirt sales. Our price is very competitive for only $15 per shirt. We have excellent quality and we will have on-time delivery. We will sell the shirts online and at local fairs. And as a social entrepreneur, we will be giving 50% of the profit to fund education for autism through grants to schools to supplement resources. This will be marketed to families and friends affected with autism. My product will be specially designed t-shirts with a special message. They will be sold online for $15. I will promote my product through social media sites such as Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and other websites that are affiliated with autism. Okay. The sales price is $15 with a purchase price of $5. I will offer a $2 commission for every t-shirt sold. The total variable expenses is $7 with a contribution margin of $10. My fixed annual expenses will be $3,800, including $1,200 for marketing and sales, including traveling, selling to local fairs, and autism events. My conservative projection of 2,000 sales in the first year with a price of $15 equals $30,000 in sales. After subtracting expenses and taxes, I will have a profit of $5,490. The total of my startup investment will be $1,300 plus an emergency fund of $1,000 and a 6-month reserve for fixed expenses of $1,900. This brings my total startup cost of $4,200. I plan to invest $500 of my personal savings. Families and friends have already pledged to give me $700 for my startup, and I'm seeking an investment of $3,000 for a 20% interest in my company. My return on sales will be 18.3%. My return on investment will be 130.7, an incredible 130.7. My break even will be a total of 380 units. The reason I chose this idea is because I'm also autistic, and it's very kind of difficult But then, I really want to be a voice for people who have an issue with autism that feel like they don't belong. It's a bad issue. They think it's a problem, but it's just a learning disability. It makes you learn different. And I have family members who have been affected with this disorder, and I want to be a voice for people to say that we're proud. It's not a bad thing. It's a gift. It's just a learning gift. And thank you for your consideration. And
questions.
Yeah, great job. You did a really excellent job. I loved your closing too, because I would have never guessed that you had any issue with autism. You did such a good job.
So it's like trying to keep it together.
We all try to keep it together. You did a really good job. Your really target market is trying to find some cool graphics and imagery that you can sell to the people that want to support.
It's find someone that's affiliated with autism that they want to be brave. They want to be brave for their disability, their disorder. But it's not mostly like to sell like for fashion. It's mostly to raise awareness and have more respect and more cautious awareness for the disorder, for autism.
Yeah, one question or one suggestion is you may want to talk to the person who went right before you, Fell Design. You guys team up together because you could be an awesome team, because it's all going to be about the graphics and the imagery that people are going to want to buy something cool and support your cause. So,
yes. Yeah. Okay.
He stole my comment. No, really, your enthusiasm and passion for this really important subject to raise awareness and education is really wonderful, and I appreciate it. I'm just wondering, and I agree you should get together with Fel. I'm just wondering if you see other product opportunities beyond T-shirts, other clothing or any other products that really might put a surge on what your ultimate mission is to create awareness and educate.
I believe that there are other ideas than T-shirts. There's more mostly for schools for posters or for anything affiliated with autism, basically.
Excellent presentation.
Thank
just
you.
One bit of advice and then a question. Are you familiar with the UCSB Center for Autism Research?
No, I'm not aware of
that. It's one of the leading research places for autism. You might want to try and get in touch with them, because if you can hook up with them, you'll get your message out working with them. My question is, if your sales are online, you have a $2 commission. You had a $2 commission.
A $2 commission for online sales. Like for every T-shirt sold, we offer a $2 commission.
Your online sales. Who's getting the $2 commission if you're selling it?
I am.
Okay.
That's the right answer. You may not have to pay your $2 commission, is what you're saying. Yeah.
All right. Thank you so much. Nice job. Thank you so much, Katie. Next up, we have SGC, Gluten Free Bakery, Sarahi Guzman. Oh man, judges, I want to be in your seat right now. Okay. Judges, are you ready? Okay, and Chris? Okay then. Great.
Did you know that there are 18 million people diagnosed with gluten sensitivity in America? With the numbers rising, there is more of a need for gluten-free products. Well, I'm here with a solution. I'm Sarah E. Guzman, and I'm here with the SGC Gluten-Free Bakery. With almost all gluten-free products frozen or packaged for long shelf life, I want to provide the community with fresh gluten-free products. I have decided to have a partnership with my mom, Laura Guzman, because me and my mom have been baking gluten-free products and have been creating recipes for a couple years now. My opportunity is that there are no other gluten-free bakeries in the community right now. I recognize that I could not do this on my own, so I have my mom, Laura Guzman, as a baker and recipe maker, Pablo Cancino, who will help with marketing, and Carolina Vargas with my business startup. My strengths are that my products are local, fresh, and gluten-free. My weaknesses are that of the expensive ingredients and the higher prices. My opportunity, of course, is no other gluten-free bakeries, and my threat is the startup cost and establishing clientele. While other bakeries who sell gluten-free products are either online or are packaged for long shelf life, my gluten-free products will be fresh every day, and there is a competitive lineup of 350. A sample of my prices is a cupcake will be $3.50, cookies are $1.50, and a banana bread is $20. I will promote my business with flyers, business cards, social media, a website, and coupon ads. An average unit will be $20. $20. An average family will purchase $20 worth of products, which will buy them either 4 cupcakes or a loaf of banana bread, which will it will cost $3.09 to make one unit, and the labor per unit will be $1.50. After my contribution margin after all variable expenses will be $15.41. My annual fixed expenses will consist of a depreciation of $1,500 per year for items, and the rent will be $12,000. We will be renting a building, a 400 square foot building with an already built-in kitchen. And the salary of employees will be $40,656, and they will be the person who is managing the storefront, which will be the annual fixed expenses will be $68,556. My total sales will be $154,000, which is 25 sales per day and 2 customers per hour. After all variable expenses and fixed operating expenses and profit after taxes, I will make $42,586. My startup equipment and including the emergency fund with reserved fixed expenses for 6 months, not 3 months, will give me a total startup investment of $49,878. My return on sales will be almost 28%, and my return on investment will be 85%. My break-even units will be 44.48. I personally have gluten sensitivity, so I know what it is, and I am very passionate about this bakery because I've been baking gluten-free for years because I've had to, and I already have experience with this because I've already been catering to places like the gluten-free products and managing sales, so I am really confident in my business and that I could do this. So thank you for your consideration.
Judges.
That was great. A really nice presentation. And I have to say, I've eaten a lot of gluten-free products. This is really good.
That's the point. It doesn't have to taste different. It has to taste the same.
And that's right. That the real test is, could you tell that it's gluten-free if you didn't know? And I would not be able to.
Thank you.
Just one kind of point of order question. I was a little confused. Is the bakery, and you found space for it, also your storefront as well?
Yes.
Your point of sales?
Yes.
Okay, great. And just to follow up, I guess, there's no other gluten-free bakery in Lompoc. Is there any in the Santa Barbara area?
There is some, but they have, there's like one that just does cakes, and that's not what I want to do. I want to have different pastries, a variety of stuff.
Okay, thank you very much.
I'll second the comments on the quality of this. I would never have guessed it was gluten-free. It's really delicious.
Thank you.
Just one question. issue of spoilage, you know, your stuff doesn't have a long shelf life, right? It's designed to be baked and sold the same day or within.
Yeah, fresh.
So how do you manage that?
Well, I wouldn't want to start up like really big. I want to be on the conservative side and be I wouldn't know how to answer that very well, but I mean, we only did say 2 sales per hour, and that we wouldn't, if we were saying 2 sales per hour, then we wouldn't bake that much, because starting up a business, I know, is very difficult. So I wouldn't bake over a lot of stuff.
Thank you.
Yeah.
yeah, great cupcake. Thank you. have you thought about the, because you get 2 components to your business. One is the baking and delivering and getting it to the customer. And mm-hmm. then the other thing is the whole real estate involved with running the mm-hmm. store and everything. Have you thought about the option of launching your business based on what, on your product, and maybe it's delivery, or you even better yet, bake in advance for them? Have you thought about that?
Oh, well, like I said, I've already had experience. My mom and I have been baking from our home for quite a while, and we're ready to expand. We've always catered to other people, and people have ordered our products. So, yeah.
Thank you.
All right. That's it. Thank you so much. Nice work. I wanted one though. Okay, next we have up ASDI Tutoring with Edgardo Guerrero. Did I get it right? Awesome. Okay.
Do you know how difficult it is to find a tutor that's affordable, reliable, and effective? Well, with ASDI, it's simple. I am Edgardo Guerrero from Lompoc High School, and I'm here to present to you ASDI. Let's face it, hiring private tutors is expensive. I'm here to offer you the opportunity to invest with me and make tutoring affordable and satisfying. ASDI is a one-call tutoring service that matches our customers' needs with our tutors' expertise. My management team consists of Sue Copeland, FBLA and Cash Academy advisor, and Jane Baer, marketing manager of Lompoc's Launchpad, and Tim Harrington from the SBDC, who I will be working with. ASDI will charge a rate of $20 an hour, and the quality of our service is excellent, since our students have excelled in the courses in which our customers request assistance in. My target market is students from elementary through high school in Lompoc. I will promote my business by sending out flyers, business cards, social media such as Facebook, and notifying teachers so they have us in mind when parents ask for help. Our selling price per unit is $20, with a cost of goods sold of $12 an hour. Our total variable expenses remains at $12 per unit, leading to a contribution margin of $8 an hour. The annual salaries of our employees, which in this case are our tutors, I came up with an estimate of $500 and an estimate of $100 for advertisement and $200 for utilities, in like telephone service. This brings my total average annual fixed expenses to $800. Our total amount of units sold is 528, which with a rate of $20 an hour leads to a total sales of over $10,000. After subtracting our expenses, we're left with a pre-tax profit of nearly $3,500. And with a tax of 10%, or $324, we're left with a net profit of $3,100, sorry. Since I will be running my business from home, and it's a startup business, I will only need minimal purchases. And these purchases will include a computer and business cards, which I came to a projection of $420. And I would like to set aside $500 for an emergency fund and $400 for a reserve for fixed expenses for 6 months, leading to a total startup investment of $1,320. I plan to invest $100 from my personal savings, and I have relatives and friends who are willing to financially support me and my business. Since my I have relatives that have pledged to give me $220, I will seek an investor that will invest $1,000 in ASDI with a 10% equity. My return on sales is 29.35%, meaning for every dollar of sales, 29 cents is profit. And my return on investment is 234.84%, meaning that in a year, the investment will be doubly paid off. And my break-even units is a mere 100 units. A mere 100 units and everything else is gravy. You should invest with me because I have strong organizational skills. I have many friends and acquaintances who I have previously tutored. I am also an honor student with a 4.1 GPA and an award-winning active member of Future Business Leaders of America. I've also participated in volunteer income tax assistance in which I prepared taxes for my community. Remember, we are the solution to your problem. Affordable, reliable, and effective. Thank you for your consideration, and I'm now open to questions.
One quick question. How are you going to decide who to recruit to be a tutor for each topic?
Okay, so the people who apply for to be a tutor for my business will require a transcript in which we will see the courses they've taken, and they will be decided depending on whether they have had like an A in the class.
Great, good presentation. One question I had on your fixed costs, because I think you got a great target market and a business model here that. But I was trying to understand how you had for an entire year, was it $500 or $800 is your total cost? Does that pay for all the students to do all this, all the different teaching? I noticed a total, fixed operating cost of $800. Was that the actual payment to the students who are going to be doing the teaching?
Oh, not everything. It's including...
Or the $500.
It's $500 for this... salaries of the employees, because since it's a startup business, I don't plan on having like too many tutors or too many customers.
So what does that equal as far as how much you're having to pay your students was the question. Is it $10 an hour or something like that?
Yeah, that's actually
wasn't it 12? Your split is you pay them 12 an hour and you take 8 of the 20?
Yeah, it's $10 an hour for the tutor, but with the cost of goods sold, with the payroll taxes, it would cost us a total of $12 an hour, and the other $8 is our profit.
Perfect. Okay, great. Thank you so much. Okay, great. Thank you, Edgardo. And next up, we have Happy Hounds Pet Service and Vincent Ruiz. We're good to go? Okay, Chris, are you ready? All right, when you're ready.
Okay. Are you too busy or not physically capable to give your dogs the walks that it deserves? Well, if you are, you come to the right business. My name is Vincent Ruiz, and I'm from Lompoc High School, California. Lompoc High School. Our mission statement is to offer a quality pet service at an affordable price. In my management, I have Sue Copeland and David Dean, who are LHS Business Academy teachers who are experts in accounting and web and app design. I also have Jane Baer, who is a Launchpad marketing advisor, and Colby Turnquist, who is a vet technician. I'll also be working with Tim Harrison from SBCC. So Lompoc has a population of 43,509, and of that, 3,335 of that are elderly. So this is a service that isn't being tended to, but it is very profitable. Our strengths. We will work with your needs of your busy schedule. Like as if you need your dog taken out and walked in the middle of the day, I'll take time from my lunch to go and give your dog the walk that it wants. I'll also be able to provide local students with a part-time job Now, our weaknesses. Now, it will be hard to spread the name of our word just by the name of mouth for the first 3 months, so our initial sales will grow as our name grows. Opportunity. We'll be able to give the commuting men and women that aren't there to help or walk their dogs throughout the day. And we will also be able to provide local students with a part-time job since Lompoc doesn't really have that many part-time jobs and students are too shy to go out there and go through all the stuff that is needed to be a threat. An employee that would wish to quit or is fired might want to take the customer with them. So we will have all employees sign a non-compete agreement that will state that they will not be able to contact the customer of any services for a minimum of 2 years. Our promotion. We'll be promoting our business through social media that includes Facebook and Instagram. We will also be spread through the word of mouth, and we'll place business cards at local vets and pet services. Our price is for 30 minutes is $10 for one dog and $15 for two dogs. The selling price per unit is $10. Our cost of goods per unit is $6, and then we get a contribution margin of $4. So our total annual fixed expenses is $360, $350 of which are for insurance and $10 for our business cards. We predict to sell 528 units that will let us have $5,280. After variable expenses and taxes, we stand to make $1,577. For the total startup investment, we would need $850, $300 for emergency fund, and then for reserve for fixed expenses up to 6 months. So I believe in my business, so I am willing to provide $350 as initial investment, and I'm looking for an investment of $500 with a 15% equity. So our return on sales is 29.9% with an astounding return on investment of 185.8%. Our break-even unit is 90 walks and everything that will be around 2.5 months, and everything after that is pure profit. Now, why I think that I'm in the position to do this business is because I have 4 years of experience. I am in the Lompoc football team and swim team, so I have great stamina. And I just have a passion for dogs. I've grown up with dogs all my life. And I just want to thank you all for considering me and giving me a chance to speak today.
Nice presentation. I wonder if you are concerned about recruiting walkers under the requirement of this multi-year non-compete requirement. I mean, in other words, if it's too onerous, it might be hard to recruit people to do your work, right? How do you overcome? How do you deal with that? And also, how do you enforce it if that did happen?
So if it did, I would go to a legal advisor. And would get it read over and get it written up. And then I would talk to the employee and explain to him why I would need it and why it would be a need for my business. But
so you might need a little bit of a legal budget.
Yeah. There we go.
Good presentation. I've got three dogs, so and I walk them. Will your walkers walk more than one family's dog at a time? I mean, I see it in cities. You see these people with 10 dogs on a leash or something. How are you going to deal with that? You know,
Well, I want to make sure that the dog walkers are capable of walking a dog of various sizes. So I will be shadowing them for the first two walks, and it will from that assessment I'll be able to say if they are able to just walk one family's dog or two dogs. From two different families.
Okay, thanks.
So. I was looking at the 528 units. Have you done like a little market analysis based on how many of those, you know, you did a population analysis, but I just wondered how many people of those that population would actually need a dog walker. I'm curious as to what the market is.
Well, I've surveyed around 50 people who do have dogs from my church or just from around town, and 70% of them do say that they would love their dog to be walked. 10% said maybe, and 5% said no, that they walk their own dogs. So,
great, thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, we've arrived at our final team. Up next is Ecologica with Pablo. Judges, are you ready? Okay, and how about you, Chris? Good, okay.
Hello, my name is Pablo Valadares and I'm here to talk about Ecologica. Ecologica is an environmentally conscious clothing company with the objective to solve issues such as pollution and waste. Pollution and waste are huge problems in our society and community, with waste being one of the key factors in problems such as disease and water contamination. Well, the way Ecologica is going to solve that problem is with t-shirts. We are an environmentally conscious clothing company that will portray the issue we're going to solve in our t-shirts, increasing awareness, while also donating 25% of our profits to a nonprofit organization to help solve the issue we portray. Well, what companies do we benefit? We plan on working both locally and globally, locally working with organizations such as Earth Day and the Donzana Cafe, while globally working with Zero Waste and even maybe Greenpeace. All of these are companies that are pushing for a healthier lifestyle and are all environmentally conscious and want a healthier planet. This takes us to our business model. Our business model is a simple yet effective trip bottom line business model where we sell our t-shirts, resulting in profit, which will allow us to invest into nonprofit organizations that will help solve the issue. Not only are we having a positive impact on the environment, a triple bottom line, but helping solve this issue also is awesome for a brand. Well, marketing. We're marketing the millennials. They're 20-year-olds who are socially aware and environmentally conscious and are willing to spend more for a positive concept. That's why we're gonna market through both social media and local events. Millennials are always on Facebook, always on Twitter. That's why we're gonna hit them. We're gonna use websites such as WordPress, MailChimp, as I said, Facebook and Twitter to get the word out. Also working local events such as Earth Day, Soul Food Festival, and SB Marathon. Market analysis. Well, a study made by ConCom in 2013 showed that 91% of people care about a company's positive impact, while staggering 58%, more than half, have already purchased a product from one of these companies in the past 12 months. Sales. Well, I plan on Ecologica being in e-commerce. The e-commerce is a $48 billion industry, and I already purchased a Shopify account where I will be able to sell my product to people all over the globe from all sorts of markets. However, I still plan on working locally. This was last year at Earth Day where I sold out my first batch of shirts, which show the proven concept that people care about a company's positive impact. Advisory board. Well, my advisory board is full of people with or managerial experience or educated about the environment. Most are both. The first two main are my parents, who apart from being lovely people, are also the heads of Instituto Perene, a nonprofit organization that helps solving air pollution in rural parts of Brazil. Mrs. B and Elizabeth Avila are gonna be the heads of the Donzana Cafe next year, which is my head company, which will help me a lot learning about the managerial aspects of owning a company. And last but not least, Jose Caballero. He's the AP Environmental Science teacher at Santa Barbara High School, and he'll be able to clarify and explain any question or issue I have regarding the environment or educational purpose. Well, financial analysis for a single t-shirt. As you can see, we have a very competitive price, with both Arbor Apparel and Storm Brown selling at a much higher price than us. And those are really only two real competitors, with Storm Brown being a local women's clothing company that uses organic materials, and Arbor being a global company that has a positive impact. Because our shirts are made out of hemp, which is a very positive material for the environment and uses much less water than cotton, we'll be selling them for $8. It'll cost us $8 to make while we sell for $25. That results in a 52% net profit, which will then in turn spend 25% of that net profit into investing into one of these nonprofit organizations that are going to help us solve the issue. That in turn results in a 9.75 or 40% profit for our whole business. That's after all the costs and all the issues. and everyone who's in the t-shirt business with a 40% margin is really high. Well, funds needed. I'm not ready to give you guys an evaluation of my company yet. However, I am ready to ask for $1,000 because I know that I need that amount of money to spend in three main topics. The first one's legal issues. I want to make Ecologica and FPC a flexible purpose company, which is a for-profit company with a nonprofit philosophy, while also trademarking the name Ecologica. I then will need $200 for the Shopify online account. I've already purchased the first month, and then the resting $200 will allow me to keep this thing going for two years. Last thing is batches. I need supply. So I'm gonna spend half of the money into supplies so when the demand comes, I can provide. Thank you very much. My name is Paul Valdaris, and this was Ecologica.
Great presentation. Just one question on, where are you gonna produce this?
Okay, great question. So the t-shirts were made. We have the Don's and Cafe, my parent company, has a standing relationship with Ecotopia, Hemptopia, which is a company that produces t-shirts made out of hemp. So we're gonna get the hemp out of there. The Don's and Cafe also has a company behind it called Design and Cut, which is about to purchase a sublimation machine, which is what we need to make these t-shirts. So all the producing will be made at a very low cost and in our facility at Santa Barbara High School.
A question, what was the link with the reducing the plastics? How does that tie into the t-shirt manufacturing? Or
all right.
Explain that.
So the main thing about this is waste currently is a huge problem, both in society, community, and globally. And people are not as aware as that as you'd think. So what we need is two main things. We need awareness, and we need to fund companies that are helping solve the problem. Zero Waste is a nonprofit organization that wants to reduce waste because it takes so much energy and money to get rid of it. And it has, as I said, very serious problems such as water contamination and disease. So by portraying the issue we want to solve of reducing waste, we'll be increasing awareness about the issue. People will see it and they'll be part of a group that is aware. And that is important because as we get young people, the millennials, to worry about environment, worry about our community, that will result in a better planet. So it ties to the problem of plastic bags. It ties to the issue of water usage, the drought we currently have in Santa Barbara. All these will tie in to the main mission that is to increase awareness and fund companies that will actually have a positive impact. I hope that answered your question.
Really nice presentation. Just one question. In addition to your you know, positive environmental branding and mission, and the environmental impact of the t-shirts out of hemp, they have to be appealing for people to buy.
Yes.
Are you going to have a dedicated design team, or I mean, how do you go about deciding on design?
All right, so I have two main things to say about this one. The first is one that this design of t-shirt, where it's a blank t-shirt with the big print, I usually pass my summers in Brazil, that's where I'm from. And if you go to Brazil, everyone uses this type of t-shirt. So not only is there a global market to it, which once I plan to expand because of my roots there, I also plan on working with other high school run businesses. That's the great thing about being in high school and being part of a program such as Don's and Cafe. It allows us to create relationships where people want to help each other, and it's synergy. So working with Fell Designs, working with Common Ground, those all will be opportunities for me to expand my business while also helping them.
Thank you.
Thank you, judges. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, nice work. All right, so this is how this is gonna work. Just as it's done traditionally, we are going to start with announcing third place first, and then second place, and then finally first place. Great. So with that, let's go ahead and get going. The judges know who they have chosen, and I do not. So let's give them a drum roll, please. And third place is?
I make a comment before we do this. This is really interesting, and all of you students really deserve an award because you what you'll learn is it's not so much your idea, it's what you learned in getting up here and doing this. So hopefully you all feel really good about the process that you were involved with. So, you know, we sit up here and we even had differences of opinion between us. So we've had to work that one out. But the third place in the competition goes to the Blue Puzzle Project.
Second place?
So before I announce second place, of course, I want to echo what was just said. This was really fun for me, and you know, just seeing everybody's enthusiasm is really the big win for me. That's what entrepreneurs need, and just keep to your ideology about building a great business, and you'll be successful. So second place, I'm pleased to announce, goes to SGC Gluten-Free Bakery. The way to a judge's heart is definitely through his stomach.
We're ready for more of those. That would be great.
I'm going to echo their comments. It's really impressive what you all do. When I was in high school, this wasn't on the radar map of things we were thinking about doing, so it's really impressive that that many people want to compete and practice doing this, and it's a great learning experience, and it's, you know, it's the first step, with, you know, no matter where you place. And the number one is Fell Design.
Fell Design.
We had an honorable mention. I know that's not one of the awards, and we just felt like we wanted to recognize one of the other sort of standouts to us. And again, this is a tough decision for us as judges because all of you guys did such a good job. But the other one that stood out in our mind was Finding Common Ground, one of the first presenters. So we'd like to give them an honorable mention.
So Finding Common Ground, come on up as honorable mention. That's great. Fabulous. Congratulations. Congratulations, everyone. Judges, I'm wondering if you have any other feedback to these winners up here, and then perhaps after we wrap up here, if other teams have questions, maybe they could approach you for a few minutes that way. So proceed as it fits for you.
Okay, we'll do this the way we have. Yeah. You know, first of all, my comments to everybody out here, because the fact that you guys got up and competed and did this is really what this competition is all about. So really, what you learned and what you experienced and what you'll take with you isn't so much your idea. All of you guys did great jobs. So we want to say, you know, you're a winner just for being here and being on stage in high school. We couldn't say enough great things about just being here. And to you guys on stage, take this as a little vote of encouragement to keep going for it. It's not so much even your idea, but the fact that you're up here and you're presenting and you're being an entrepreneur and going for it. So, you know, congratulations, and we're excited to see where all this goes.
Great. Thank you.
I'm just going to notice what I'm sure everybody does. There's five women up here.
I know that, yeah.
That's awesome. That's really just thrilling.
And we didn't know that when we were adding these numbers up. So
no, no, not at all. Not at all. We're too busy with other things. So, no, really. Great job. Look, the winner, for me, and I'll kind of make this comment global about all of you. You know, again, everybody was great, and it's hard to pick winners. But for the people standing on the stage, I think, for me, what separated you out was that there was a seriousness of purpose. Everybody had passion. Here there was a real seriousness of purpose and dedication to planning, thinking ahead, understanding what all the elements that you needed to get together were, and addressing each of them in a coherent way. So those are the elements of building a great business, and I really congratulate all of you.
Nice, thank you.
Tough to add anything after your comments, but really the excellence of the work and the amount of work it took to produce this is very impressive, and everyone has done a great job at that, and you know, good luck going forward.
Okay, let's give everyone a hand. Well, if you can believe it, that's a wrap on the 5th annual Scheinfeld New Venture Challenge, and we hope to see you here again next year. And let's give a final big warm applause to our judges. Thank you so much.